بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Welcome, my brothers in Islam, to our 48th lesson of Al-Arabiyyatu Bayn Yadayk, Book 1, Part 1 of the New Version. In this lesson, the 48th lesson, we will start, inshallah, with the new page, that is page 17, inshallah. As-safhatu as-sabi'ata ashrata, the 17th page. ونجد في أعلى الصفحة we find at the top of the page عند الخلفية البيضاء أو عند الخلفية البيضاء at the white background we find the word الكلام. الكلام، ما معنى الكلام؟ What means الكلام؟ الكلام أيها الإخوة أصله its origin is كلام، because when you drop the L you get the two dhamma back. كلام، ومعنى كلام، the meaning of كلام is the talk or the speech. Talk or speech. It can also mean talking or speaking. So هو يحب الكلام مثلا. It's a sentence. هو يحب الكلام. He loves talking. As I've maybe mentioned before, that L is not always translated as the. Okay. Like here, he loves talking. He loves speaking. هو يحب الكلام. Okay. If I say أما as for if I say هو يحب كلاما. هو يحب كلاما. Then he loves a talk. He loves a speech. Okay. It becomes like more specified, more specific. So most of the times L has been translated as the English the, but not always. Okay. أنا أحب الدجاجة. I love chicken. As you can hear, if you have heard, I have used L. أنا أحب الدجاجة. أنا أحب دجاجا. I love a chicken. You know, it becomes a bit different. أنا أحب الخبزة. I love bread. أنا أحب خبزا. I love a bread. Okay, a specific type of bread. So L is not always the. Anyway, كلام is speech, and as very famous from the ulama of the Salaf, the ulama of the pious predecessors, they say, القرآن كلام الله. Okay, القرآن is the speech of Allah. So, الكلام, the speech. التدريب الأول, the first exercise, تبادل الحوار مع زميلك كما في المثال. Exchange the conversation with your classmate like in the example. مثال, an example. الطالب الأول, the first student. اسمي فاطمة. أنا مصرية. أنا من مصر. نعم. So اسمي فاطمة. My name is فاطمة. And as I've mentioned before, أنا فاطمة is I am فاطمة. But the one we have here is my name is فاطمة. اسمي فاطمة. And if you stop because of the comma, you say اسمي فاطمة. You give it the ha sound. أنا مصرية. I am Egyptian. So here we have the nationality, جنسية. أنا من مصر. ومصر اسم بلد. مصر is the name of a country, Egypt. I'm from Egypt. And مصر becomes مصر here because the one dhamma when affected by the preposition حرف جر, what is من, from, it gets a فتح instead of كسرة. نعم. إذن من is a حرف جر, it's a preposition. And then أهلا وسهلا, we have أهلا وسهلا, what is welcome. يعني the reply of أهلا وسهلا can be شكرا, thanks. And the reply of شكرا will then be عفوا, you're welcome, or no problem. Inshallah you start now, my brothers in Islam. We have here four pictures. You either do it by yourself if you're alone. So you're mentioning all the sentences, both sentences yourself. And if you are with a classmate, then you exchange, as you can see in the top of the page, تبادل exchange. يعني you do one time, you do the first line, and your classmate does the second line. And then you exchange. Then he starts and you reply. ابدأوا الآن, start now. طيب سأبدأ الآن إن شاء الله بالتدريب. I will start now with the exercise. ويمكنك أن تعيد. And you are, it's possible for you to repeat. خلفي, behind me. اسمي محمود. أنا تركي. أنا من تركيا. أهلا وسهلا. اسمي خديجة. أنا سورية. أنا من سوريا. أهلا وسهلا. اسمي علي. أنا باكستاني. أنا من باكستان. أهلا وسهلا. اسمي أحمد. أحمد is exception because it has the same pattern of a verb. Normally male names have two dhamma like علي محمود. أحمد it looks like أذهب, I go. What's a present tense verb, so it has only one dhamma. أحمد, نعم. اسمي أحمد. أنا مصري. أنا من مصر. أهلا وسهلا. To get the full benefit inshallah of this exercise, you can rewind and see what I have mentioned and just said as a dictation. So you write everything down what I've just mentioned, starting with اسمي محمود. أنا تركي. أنا من تركيا. أهلا وسهلا. Write it all down and inshallah it will help. It will have a huge benefit, inshallah, for your vocabulary and as well for your writing style and handwriting. Now, التدريب الثاني. تبادل الحوار مع زميلك كما في المثال. ترجم. Translate, brother. Exchange the conversation with your classmate like in the example. I've mentioned before, zamiluka is the root, but ma'as mudaf, meaning the word after, gets a kasra. Normally it's zamiluka, your classmate. Okay, it can also be your colleague, but not in this context. Mithalun, an example. الطالب الأول the first student هذا أخي. As you see, I've put the alif between the ha and the dal. That is a must to be pronounced, but forbidden to be written. هذا alif between the ha and the dal. هذا أخي. هو مدرس. أهلا وسهلا. This is my brother. He's a teacher. Welcome. They could also only say marhaban, what is also welcome. And this is one of the two words for welcome. Ahlan wa sahlan or marhaban. So you start now, inshallah. And what you have to do is you put all these four words that are in the beginning of each picture. You put each one of them in the my form. Okay, so akhun has become now akhi. Because if you say akhun, it's a brother. Hada akhun, this is a brother. And that's not what has to be done here. And then you add the suitable pronoun. With the teacher, you say huwa. What is he? That's the suitable pronoun here. So you start now, inshallah. And then exchange with your classmate. And if you're alone, you do both sentences, inshallah. Bismillah, you start now. With the name of Allah. طيب. سأبدأ الآن إن شاء الله. I will start now إن شاء الله. هذه أختي. هي طبيبة. أهلا وسهلا. هذا صديقي. هو مهندس. أهلا وسهلا. هذه صديقتي. هي طالبة. أهلا وسهلا. هذا أخي. هو طالب. أهلا وسهلا. What you do now, inshallah, you rewind and see this as a dictation. So you write down each thing I've just mentioned, starting with هذه أختي. Likewise, you're going to write the translation next to the dictation. اكتب الترجمة بجانب الإملاء. Write the translation next to the إملاء, the dictation. وسأبدأ الآن بالترجمة إن شاء الله. And I will start now with the translation, إن شاء الله. This is my sister. She is a doctor. Welcome. This is my friend. He is an engineer. Welcome. This is my friend, female friend. She is a student. Welcome. This is my brother. He is a student. Welcome. الصفحة التالية, the next page. التدريب الثالث. تبادل الحوار مع زميلك كما في المثال. Exchange the conversation with your classmate like or as in the example. مثال. السلام عليكم. وعليكم السلام. كيف حالك؟ بخير والحمد لله. ما جنسيتك؟ أنا باكستاني. أهلا وسهلا. الترجمة translation. You always translate before I do. So after السلام we have كيف حالك. How are you? Literally, how's your situation? Masculine. Fine. And all praise is due to Allah. What is your nationality? Your masculine. I am Pakistani. Welcome. كتبت ملاحظة. I've written a note. بخير والحمد لله. عادة normally, عادة means normally, نضع, we put, فاصلة, a comma, بعد, after, بخير, وقبل, and before, والحمد لله. So, normally, so if you want, you can put a comma after بخير. ابدأ الآن, inshallah, you start now, my brothers in Islam. But with the first picture, Turkiyatun. Okay, so the salam stays the same. And after that, there are some important changes after the salam. So you start now, inshallah. Bismillah. سأبدأ الآن إن شاء الله. We'll start now إن شاء الله. And you can also use this as a dictation to get the full benefit إن شاء الله. السلام عليكم. وعليكم السلام. Likewise you can say السلام عليك وعليك السلام. كيف حالك؟ The kasra below the calf. بخير والحمد لله. ما جنسيتك؟ أنا تركية. أهلا وسهلا. السلام عليكم. وعليكم السلام. كيف حالك؟ بخير والحمد لله. ما جنسيتك؟ أنا سوري. أهلا وسهلا. السلام عليكم. وعليكم السلام. كيف حالك؟ كيف حالك؟ بخير والحمد لله. ما جنسيتك؟ أنا مصرية. أهلا وسهلا. السلام عليكم. وعليكم السلام. كيف حالك؟ بخير والحمد لله. ما جنسيتك؟ أنا تركي. أهلا وسهلا. التدريب الرابع. The fourth exercise. تبادل الحوار مع زميلك كما في المثال. Exchange the conversation with your classmate like in the example. We go from right to left. من اليمين إلى الشمال. ما اسمك؟ الطالب المثال, the example. الطالب الأول, the first student. ما اسمك؟ الطالب الثاني, the second student. اسمي بدر. من أين أنت؟ أنا من تركيا. هل أنت تركي؟ نعم أنا تركي. أهلا وسهلا. ابدأوا الآن إن شاء الله. You start now إن شاء الله. سواء whether بوحدك, سواء وحدك whether alone, أو مع زميلك or with your classmate. ابدأوا الآن. سأبدأ الآن إن شاء الله. If I start too early for you, you always pause it until you finish the exercise. This is the rule. Okay, brothers. هناك ملاحظة. There is a note. هناك خطأ. What does that mean? هناك خطأ. There is a mistake. هناك خطأ. The plural form. الجمع أخطاء, mistakes. هناك خطأ في الصورة الأولى. There is a mistake in the first picture. بسبب الفرق, because of the difference, بين between الخريطة, between the map, وهي لتركيا, and that's of Turkey, meaning the map, وبين كتابة باكستان, and between the writing of Pakistan. Okay, يعني there is a mistake there. The rest is all, the other two pictures, they're all fine. Because سوريا, you see the map of Syria. مصر, you see the map, خريطة, the map of مصر. So they should put Pakistan within the map. So they should remove Turkey and put Pakistan within the map. And they are not to blame, because a mistake, all of us make mistakes. So the first one is all about Pakistan. So you start now inshallah, or I think you finished now by now inshallah. سأبدأ. I will start. You can repeat إن شاء الله. ما اسمك؟ اسمي إقبال. من أين أنت؟ أنا من باكستان. هل أنت باكستاني؟ نعم أنا باكستاني. أهلا وسهلا. You can use this today also as a dictation. It will only benefit you, inshallah. ما اسمك؟ اسمي أنور. من أين أنت؟ أنا من سوريا. هل أنت سوري؟ نعم أنا سوري. أهلا وسهلا. ما اسمك؟ اسمي سعيد. من أين أنت؟ أنا من مصر. هل أنت مصري؟ نعم أنا مصري. أهلا وسهلا. I think everything's quite clear. I'll just translate the first one. For those brothers who have written the dictation, they can write the translation next to it. I think by translating only the example, the rest is clear, inshallah, because you should know now these country names and these nationalities. So the example says, what is your name, Masaklin? My name is Badr. Where are you from? Or literally, from where are you? I'm from Turkey. Are you Turkish? Yes, I'm Turkish. Welcome. There are some extra benefits, inshallah. أولاً, إقبال بضمتين, with two dhammas. اسم علم مذكر عربي. It's a proper noun, what is masculine in Arabic. It's an Arabic masculine proper noun. وهو من أشهر الأسماء, and it's from the most famous names في باكستان, in Pakistan. إقبال. تقول مثلا, you say for example, just to give you the meaning of this name, الإقبال كبير. الإقبال كبير. What is إقبال here? Or الإقبال, if you put L before, is the turnout. The turnout, the attendance or the turnout is كبير, big. Meaning many people have attended. ومثال المعنى الثاني, and the example or an example of the second meaning, لهذا الاسم, of this name. So إقبال has two meanings, turn out. And the second meaning is like here, in this example. إقبال الأتراك على تعلم اللغة العربية كبير. The إقبال of the Turkish people, أتراك is plural. This is the plural of Turkiyun. هذا جمع Turkiyin. So Turkiyun is one Turkish person and Atrakun is the plural. I think we have done this before. So, what does Iqbalun here means? I'll translate the rest. The Iqbal of the Turkish people to learn the Arabic language is big. Okay, Iqbalun here means interest, or the zeal, or the enthusiasm. Okay, so going back, the interest or the zeal of the Turkish people, and or the enthusiasm of the Turkish people, and it goes with ala. Ala means on, but you cannot translate it as on in English here. So the enthusiasm and the zeal of the Turkish people to learn the Arabic language is big. Okay, so and this is actually something what is true. You find that many Turkish people, they are very interested in learning the Arabic language. You can find that, for example, on the in the videos of Ustad Suwayfi, who's a teacher in Trabzon in Turkey. He's teaching the Turkish youth the Arabic language, and you'll find, mashallah, that the Turkish people are very eager to learn in general the Arabic language. Going to Anwaru ismu alamin mudakkarin arabiyin, is an Arabic masculine proper noun. Wahua mamnu'un min as-sarfi, there's only one dhamma. Li'annahu ismu alamin, because why is it has it only one dhamma Anwaru? لأنه اسم علم, because it's a proper noun, على وزن الفعل, that has the pattern of a verb. أنور is like أحمد, okay? And أحمد and أنور, they have the same ruling of one dhamma because they have the same pattern of a verb, like adhabu, I go, aqra'u, I read, okay, aftahu, I open. And there are some other male nouns, male names, like Yazid and Ashraf. They only have also one dhamma because they're similar to a verb in the way you write them. وَهُوَ اسْمُ تَفْضِيلٍ. And Anwaru is an ismu tafdilin, and this is something I will explain in the next lesson, inshallah. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.